groundwater and streams. The interaction between the groundwater system and streams is a basic link in the hydrologic cycle. This interaction can take place in one of three ways. Streams may gain water from the inflow of groundwater through the stream bed. Such streams are called gaining streams, figure 17.8a. For this to occur, the elevation of the water table must be higher than the level of the surface of the stream. Streams may lose water to the groundwater system by outflow through the stream bed. The term losing stream is applied to this situation, figure 17.8bc. When this happens, the elevation of the water table must be lower than the surface of the stream. The third possibility is a combination of the first two, a stream gains in some sections and loses in others. Figure 17.8 interactions between the groundwater system and streams. Based on U.S. Geological Survey. Losing streams can be connected to the groundwater system by a continuous saturated zone, or they can be disconnected from the groundwater system by an unsaturated zone. Compare parts B and C in figure 17.8. When the stream is disconnected, the water table may have a discernible bulge beneath the stream if the rate of water movement through the stream bed and unsaturated zone is greater than the rate of groundwater movement away from the bulge. In some settings, a stream might always be a gaining stream or might always be a losing stream. However, in many situations, flow direction can vary a great deal along a stream. Some sections receive groundwater, and other sections lose water to the groundwater system. Moreover, the direction of flow can change over a short time span due to storms adding water near the stream bank or when temporary flood peaks move down the channel. Groundwater contributes to streams in most geologic and climatic settings. Even where streams are primarily losing water to the groundwater system, certain sections may receive groundwater inflow during some seasons. One study of 54 streams in all parts of the United States indicated that 52% of the stream flow was contributed by groundwater. The groundwater contribution ranged from a low of 14% to a maximum of 90%. Groundwater is also a major source of water for lakes and wetlands.